If you're in the market for a new home and you happen to be self-employed, you need to listen up to a few tips. In today's market, due to COVID and everything going on in this unique market we're in, if you are self-employed, getting a loan has become a little bit of a challenge. Let me explain. So first off, the process is taking so much longer than it normally does. And because of the COVID situation and people being laid off and the whole unemployment situation, lenders are being particularly cautious. And it seems like those who are self-employed are really getting the brunt of all of this caution. So in addition to all the normal documents you would complete when you're applying for a loan, there's extra information over and above what you would normally supply. And then when you get into underwriting, there seem to be extra stipulations that are being imposed on those of us who are self-employed. And then when you get to the end of the process, you know, throughout the process, the lender is checking your employment status, verifying your employment status again and again and again. We're seeing a bit of a lag time in getting a response from those they're calling to verify employment because everyone's backed up. And so the whole process has just slowed down tremendously. So instead of the typical time frame to qualify for a loan and have the whole thing processed being around 30 days, well, I'm finding that it's double that time at times. So I tell you this because if you're in this situation, if you're self-employed and you're looking to buy a home, I would strongly suggest that you go ahead and start the loan pre-approval process right away. And then just know that it's going to take time. So if you find that perfect house, you write a contract, you get it accepted, it's going to be very important that the close date that you plug into that contract allows for that period of time for your loan to get processed. And so my lender is saying 6 weeks, 8 weeks, but give yourself plenty of time. And if you'll notice in all the real estate contracts, when you drop in a closing date, it says on or before whatever the date is. So if the process happens to go much quicker, and if all parties are in agreement, then you can close sooner rather than later. But I just wanted to give you this tip today. I don't like surprises. I know you don't like surprises when you go to buy a new home. And this has become just a big deal in the world of real estate right now.